Hey there, guys. Welcome to another PIVX class. Today, we're going to be talking about multi-sig addresses. My first couple months in cryptocurrency, I heard this term a lot, but didn't really know what it meant. So why don't we talk about what they are and what they're for? Exactly how they function is a technical subject, so we'll just be talking about them in common terms. First off, multi-sig is a short form for multiple signatures. It rolls off the tongue better and saves some time. The purpose of a multi-sig address is to increase security on a cryptocurrency address. In a typical single signature address, you have one public address and one private key. In a multiple signature address, you have one public address but multiple private keys. You don't necessarily need all the keys, but it is an option. When you create a multi-signature address, you choose how many keys there are and how many are needed to make a transaction with the address. So you could choose to have three keys, but someone only needs two of them to make the transaction. You could also make an address that requires all three to work, but that is your choice. To summarize, a multi-sig address is an address that requires more than one private key to use. Where is this useful though? With current technology, you may find it difficult to keep your spending money in a multi-sig address because there isn't always a convenient, fast option to get the other keys for a transaction in a hurry. You could do this though. Having transactions require multiple keys means that someone can't steal your device to get your currency. As I said though, it might make it hard to spend your currency if you go this route. What you could do, and this is much more practical, you can have your savings kept in a multi-sig address. Since you don't intend to use this every day, and time should not be a factor in withdrawing currency from your savings, it is a very good candidate for multi-sig security. That way, if someone steals a device to keep your wallet on, they can't actually get at the money. It's a pretty solid security option. How does that work though? How are you going to get your money back in this situation? Well, if you set up the savings address with a 2 of 3 multi-sig, you can have a spare key hidden somewhere safe. 2 of 3 means that two keys are needed to make a transaction, but there are 3 keys total. Under normal circumstances, you would use your device's key, plus a key that a trusted third party holds to spend the funds. If your device is stolen and that key is gone, you get your backup hidden key and use it with the third party key to get your funds. The third party can't spend your funds because they only have one key. The thief can't spend your funds because they only have one key, but you can spend them because you have your backup key and you should have access to the third party's key. Oh, and if the third party tries to mess with you or just disappears, then you would still be able to spend your funds because you have the key on your device plus the backup key. Unless you got your device stolen at the exact same time the third party became unavailable. That would be some very bad luck though. Now we know how they work, but there's a lot of other use cases besides that one. Married couples can create joint savings accounts by creating a 2 of 2 multi-sig address. This would need both of them to agree on spending the money for it to be used. Charitable organizations can also use multi-sig to prevent any one employee from dipping into the organization's funds. You could set up a 4 of 7 multi-sig address requiring an employee to have the cooperation of 3 other key holders to spend any of the money. At the same time, it means you don't need all of the keys. It could pose kind of a problem if you need to pay a supplier and one of the key holders was on vacation. This 4 of 7 system poses a good compromise between security and accessibility. You know, I forgot perhaps what is truly the simplest use for multi-sig. Remember how I said that needing 2 keys on an address that is meant for daily use isn't really that practical with current technology? Well, I stand by that, but a 1 of 2 systems can have some value here. In a 1 of 2 system, you only need 1 key, but there are 2 around. This is useful in case you lose a key. We're all very careful, but let's be real. Sometimes we lose keys. It just happens. If you keep an extra one hidden away, you now have a backup in case you lose the main key. This has a similar effect as making proper backups, but is another way to go about it. Now, you still need proper backups. I just wanted to illustrate another use case. Anyways, there's a few examples of how multi-sig fits into the crypto world. You can use multi-sig for all sorts of things though. Trade agreements, keeping exchanges honest, children's savings accounts, and much more. Anywhere there is a need or want for stricter access to things, there is an opportunity to use multi-sig. Let's recap really quick here. Multi-sig is short for multiple signatures. It means that a public address can have more than one key and may require multiple to be used at the same time to spend funds. You may need one of two keys to spend the funds. Maybe you need two of two keys. You might need three of six or any other combination, really. It all depends on how you set it up. So next time you hear multi-sig, just think multiple keys to access. Okay, that's it for today, guys. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below and I'll be happy to help you out. Suggestions for topics to cover are always welcome as well. I like to talk about what you guys are currently most curious about, so let me know. Be sure to like and share the video. It helps me out a lot. And as always, thank you for tuning in. I love having you, and I will see you in the next PIVX class.